you know, you jump started into this new role as a Wicked Witch, and it's just exploded in this fandom. Obviously, as you can see, you have plenty of fans out here already.
My pretties.
And and it's just it's exploded in popularity. So I just want to get your thoughts and opinions on how big the show's gotten.
I mean, I don't think anybody knew, even when they were doing it from the pilot, that it was going to become such a huge, huge success. But it has absolutely exploded. The fans are so loyal, so passionate, and so faithful, and so into it that it just makes it such a pleasure to be a part of when the fans really, really, really care as much as you guys do. It's really unique.
And my question for you is, what is it like actually getting to portray the role that you get to play on Once Upon a Time as the Wicked Witch?
It's gotta be so much fun.
It's so, so wicked. I mean, playing someone like the Wicked Witch of the West is such an iconic character. It's such a, I mean, everyone keeps saying to me, oh, you know, I get asked a lot, like, oh, you know, how did you feel about, you know, taking on a role, you know, which is such a huge responsibility. And I always say, I didn't realize until I was like 2 or 3 episodes in, I was sitting on set with my hat on and my broomstick, and I'm like, oh my God, this is a massive responsibility. But it hadn't hit me until it was a little bit too late, and then I'd already established the character. But it was a very delicious role to play, because she's so awful and so horrible. And when I had my hands around Henry's neck, choking him to death, I'm like, or I had like Captain Hook in the trunk, I'm like, they're gonna hate me. They're gonna hate me. I'm horrible. But it's so much more fun to play someone really wicked and bad than playing someone super sweet. I love it. I loved it. I just love being bad. It's so much more fun.
Thank you. Thank you for that. All right, guys. So if you have any questions, we have our microphone set up at the very middle of the stage right here. So if you'd like to ask Rebecca Mader a question, please feel free to line up and ask away.
Come and talk to me.
Hey.
Hi.
My question is, when like you're doing like the magic and stuff, did it feel weird? Did it take you some time to get used to like doing like the weird like motions? But obviously nothing happens when you're doing it. You just get
man.
It is so true, because you know when we call it on the show poofing in and poofing out, when you come into a scene and magically go out of a scene. So you literally sort of step in and go, okay, great, and then you just sort of walk off. It's really, really weird. I think the weirdest thing about the magic on the show when you're shooting the magic is, you know, when you're shooting all the stuff that's in fairy tale land, it's all shot against blue screen and green screen. And obviously I had to shoot against blue screen because I was green, and if I would disappear, I would just be eyes and teeth. So I was always in front of the blue screen. But it was really weird because, like, you know, when I had that really wonderful scene with the Evil Queen, where I meet her for the first time and I'm at her castle and I'm in her dress and we're walking around. I mean, all you can see is just blue. So you don't even know where you are. So the only person that can tell you is the director of photography that has all the screens set up with the world sort of layered in. And you've got all the computer tech geeks back there layering everything in. So I run back there and look and go, oh, I'm there. Because you've got no idea. And then it's even more when you watch the episode, you're like, oh my God, I was in a castle. Because you're just essentially in a blue room going. So it's just as magical for the actors, I think. When we watch the episodes, we're seeing it for the same time, just like you lot, you know, it's really cool.
Yeah. And then also, what was your favorite scene to shoot?
Oh.
Whether like...
I've got a multitude of scenes, but I think one of my most favorite scenes to shoot was when the sisters met for the first time, because I think Lana Perilla and I have really, really, really excellent chemistry. So those two women kind of going head to head and squaring off for like this 5-minute delicious scene, I think that was definitely one of my highlights on the show, for sure.
All right, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hi there.
Hi.
I was wondering, when it came to getting the inspiration of forming the character, did you take a lot of inspiration from the original Wizard of Oz movies, from the books, from the adaptation musical Wicked, and the book by Gregory Maguire? How did you kind of form all those versions of the Wicked Witch of the West to create what you did?
I actually tried to do the complete opposite. Mm-hmm. I've obviously seen the movie. I saw the play, the musical Wicked, on Broadway in 2009. I haven't read the book yet. That's my next book I'm going to read. So
dark.
I'd seen everything, and I'd seen everyone else's, you know, adaptation of that character. So when Adam and Eddie told me that I was going to be playing the Wicked Witch of the West, I actually went out of my way to not watch them or go see it again. There was part of me that's like, oh, I should watch the film and I should go back to Broadway. But I was like, no, don't do it, Beck, because if you do it, then I was terrified of mimicking another actress.
Yeah.
So I'm like, you know what? The writers on the show are so good. I'm like, I'm just going to lie back, think of England, trust the writers, and just do my own thing, you know? And plus, you know, I'm English, so I was like, they really wanted me to play this character British. And I'm like, are you sure? Because, you know, Lana and, you know, obviously my mum, Cora, are American. They're like, no, we just think it'd be really interesting. So I knew that they were trying to do, like they always do on Once Upon a Time, put their own spin on it. So I just decided to put my own sort of British green hot sauce on it and just pray, basically, that it worked out.
And it
so
did.
I kind of just made it up.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hey, how's it going?
Good, how are you?
I'm good. Okay, so I have a question. Obviously, there's no other adaptation that, at least that I've heard of, that mixes Regina and the Wicked Witch as sisters. So how did you develop that character and that relationship?
I think that relationship essentially was developed, I mean, first and foremost, through the writing. You know, I mean, it was like a big shock that we were sisters and that I was born with magic and we had this whole thing going on. You know, so you sort of let the writers drive where it's going and just hope that that magic happens. And I think Lana is such a talented actress and I'm all right. And just the two of us together, I think we had such... It was just easy from the beginning. The minute we were first in the scene together, it was just...
It looked real natural.
It just felt right. It felt good. And it was like working with Lana, with the two of us, it was kind of like a dance, just sort of moving around, you know. It was just... I think it was just meant to be. We were meant to be sisters. I don't know.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Oh, I'm so short. Hi.
Hi. Tiptoes.
Hold on, I got you.
I don't want to break anything.
No, it's okay.
Oh, thank you. I was just wondering how the makeup process went about. I really like how I love makeup, and that's one of the favorite things I look for when I'm watching shows or movies. So
the makeup process for The Wicked Witch of the West is on petit peu intense. It takes about an hour and a half. Obviously, when I'm white in storybook, it takes 20 minutes, and I'm, you know, cup of tea, and I'm out the chair. So the green makeup is applied. A lot of people think it's CGI, but it is actually real makeup. It's spray paint. So it's paint for your face. So they have it in a machine, and it's 7 different layers of green. So it's 5 different greens, and then like an eggplant for shading, and then the last is like a gold smattering, similar to what Rumpelstiltskin has, so that when I would turn and move around, the light would kind of catch it and it makes the green glisten. So it's a really long process. So basically any skin that's showing has to be greened up. But sometimes towards the end, especially when it was as cold, I'm like, should we just put gloves on? Because the hands would take like another half an hour, and then the green nails. So we got some really fabulous green gloves for my character, and that saved about another half an hour. And it is a long process, but the makeup artist on the show is lovely, so we just chat and hang out and have a really good time and drink coffee, and then magically I would be done and be ready to get dressed.
All right, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hello.
Hello.
I'm sorry, I'm a bit nervous right now.
I can't hear you. Can I speak into the mic?
Can you speak into the microphone, please?
I'm a bit nervous right now.
Me too. It's so weird. I'm seeing it by myself.
I wanted to ask, how did it feel like working with the other actors? I'm not sure if anyone asked this question. How do you feel like working on set with Emma and the rest of the cast?
I mean, it's just. Being on Once Upon a Time is like going to college. I didn't get to go to college. I couldn't afford it. So, you know, I didn't get to have that experience. I didn't get to hang around with a bunch of people my own age and just talk about nothing or everything. And so for me, that was a really special experience because I never got to do that. So, you know, when we're not working and like in between takes, we're literally all sitting around in a circle with our chairs, with our names on it, you know, just hanging out, having a laugh, drinking Starbucks, on Twitter, talking to you lot, you know, just talking about current events. And I think besides the fact that I love acting and working with these people, and when we're all in our characters, that's fun. When everybody's being themselves, as some of my most favorite times on the show is when we're all just chilling out, having a laugh, and just talking. It's like hanging out with a bunch of friends. It's really, really lovely.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
He has a sorting
nice
hat on. That's awesome.
Yeah, I
nice.
Know. My hat's funny. That's awesome. Okay, well, my question was, when you were acting out as the Wicked Witch, how did it feel? I know you said earlier that you loved being, like, acting evil, but how did it actually feel when you were on set, like, doing the scenes?
I don't know if I can use this word. I shouldn't use that word. Let me think of an...
Keep it PG-13.
I know. I think the PG-13 version of what I really want to say is it just felt really, really delicious. There's something about that character. It felt wicked. You know, in England, wicked means, yeah, wicked. Like if something's really good and really sexy and really fun, in England, that's what wicked means. And that's what that character, that's kind of the essence that I took into that character. So when I was walking around in all the regalia and the, you know, the big witch expensive costumes and the hat and holding my broomstick and moving around the set and being horrible and looking at all the other actors and in a scene when they're all just completely terrified of me and I just catch my reflection and I'm green and I do look incredibly terrifying, I really did become that character and I felt really, really powerful and that was really one of the best feelings of my life.
Awesome. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, I have two questions. You mentioned that you didn't go to college, so how did the whole acting process start for you? Like, how did you get into the business?
I mean, getting into acting is really, really hard. I got really lucky considering I didn't go to university, college, drama school, take an acting class, anything. I kind of got backdoored into the industry in New York. I've never even acted in the UK. And I got into the business in New York purely because I was modeling at the time, which I didn't want to do that either because, I mean, I just did not want to be a model. I wanted to be an actress, you know. But the way to kind of get into the acting business in America is you need an acting agent to do television commercials. So that was kind of my transition. Like, I do, like, cheesy hair commercials where I'd flip my hair and be like, I'm so worth that. with a wind machine. And I'm like, oh, God, help me. Get me out of here. But, you know, think of the money, whatever. God save the queen. So, you know, I would do that. And then I would go to the other agents going, I can actually act. And they're like, okay, sweetie, bless you. I'm like, no, I really, really can. So they finally, I wore them down. They took some headshots. They were black and white back in the day in New York. And I started going out on auditions and I actually started booking stuff and they were like, oh, okay. But then for 6 years, I had to model and act simultaneously to pay my bills. And then in 2006, I got my first series regular role and I was able to just completely quit modeling. That was a beautiful day for me. And then I was just an actress. So I did kind of get, like, you know, backdoored into the business rather than, because I mean, I couldn't afford to go to school, you know.
And my second question was, if you could be any other character on the show besides the Wicked Witch of the West, who would you be?
Rumpelstiltskin. I'm very aware that I have boobs and that would be hard. But he's just my favorite character on the show. He is just so interesting and the character is so layered and so flawed and he can be so awful and so vulnerable. And obviously, you know, I love the Evil Queen too. And I just love the villains on the show. I think they write so well for the villains on the show that I don't know if I would even know how to play a good guy.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hi, hi, how are you?
I'm good.
First of all, I adore you. I've adored you. Thank from you. White Collar and Lost, so I'm a huge fan. My question is, oh my goodness, my question is, how did this role come to you? I mean, it's a very interesting type of thing. Hey, do you want to play the Wicked Witch on once? So how did it come to you?
Literally just like that.
Really?
Yeah. It was really weird. Adam and Eddie, who created the show, were also writers on Lost. And they had written a lot for my character Charlotte on Lost, so they knew me. We already had a pre-existing relationship. And I knew the show, and I always wanted to be on Once Upon a Time. And I thought, I bet I'm going to be Ariel. And then Ariel was someone else. I'm like, oh, whatever. I'm fine. And then one day, I think it was October 2013, I was walking the dog. And, she was doing a business, and the phone rang, and it was my agent. They're like, oh, my God, Once Upon a Time want to know if you want to be on the show. And I'm like, what? As what? They already cast Ariel. And they're like, and they were like, no, they really do. I'm like, wicked, I'm in, count me in. And they're like, well, don't you want to know what the character is? I'm like, not really. And they were like, well, they won't tell us, it's a top secret. I'm like, I don't care. And they're like, so you definitely want to do it? I'm like, yep. So I signed on to the show, not even knowing I was going to be the week. I didn't find out until like a week later, until they called me. I'm like, I mean, who doesn't want to be on a hit TV show about fairy tales and hope on ABC? I do. So it was really that easy. It was just a phone call. Which, as an actor, by the way, is amazing, because you think how many auditions we go on and how much rejection we go through. You know, it's like 14 years of like, thanks, but no. And then you just randomly get a phone call saying, do you want to be on a hit TV show? It's like, it makes it all worth it, definitely.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
So since you do play the Wicked Witch and she's so evil, was there ever a scene that was difficult for you to film?
Yeah, I think strangling Henry was not easy. And I actually hurt him a little bit. Oops. Because it was such a cold day. We were so cold. And even though I had my gloves on, I couldn't feel my hands. And I've got this poor Jared in my hands. And I'm like, rah! And I'm like, this is horrible. I'm strangling a boy. This is not normal. How did I get here? So it was really hard for me to hurt a child. It goes against everything I stand for as a woman. So I think, yeah, definitely hurting Jared was really hard.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I want to know, was it fun doing all this magic?
Yes. Yes. I think, well, the most magical thing I think the witch ever really does is fly her broomstick. And like all the magic stuff, like all the spells that you do on people, like when you vade to someone and then you poof into the room and then you poof out of the room, that stuff I don't really see until we watch the episodes like with you. So for me, the most magical thing that I really actually got to do was fly my broomstick myself. And I actually did like wear the harness around my hips underneath my witch's costume and fly up through the air and fly around through the other actors and jump off it. I mean, it was like being a kid on Christmas. It was the most magical, ridiculous thing I've ever done. It was like, pinch me and wake me up. I definitely, definitely love flying on a broomstick. It's like being on a roller coaster. It's really fast. It's fun.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
So cute.
So my question was, how did you react when you got the part?
I might have screamed. I was walking the dog, like I said, but I was like, oh my God, shut up! I do tend to say shut up when something really good happens, which my mum doesn't like that. Shut up, don't say shut up. I was like, oh my God, shut up! It's sort of like that. I'm a scream, I'm very loud, sorry. I am, I'm not a normal person. So I did scream, I was so happy and so excited.
I'm not a normal person either.
Thank you.
What goes through your mind when you're on the set and you're thinking like, what am I doing?
It's a very strange feeling, you know, when you're sort of thinking, oh, I'd like to take a nap, but I can't lean back because I'm wearing a witch's hat. I mean, that's not normal. It's not like a normal Tuesday. So there are a lot of like pinch me moments. And also, you know, I forget what I look like throughout the day. And then I'll pass a mirror and be like, oh my God, I'm green. Because you're not, you're like, you know, you're you, hanging out, having a cup of tea, some cheese, some crackers, you know, maybe some cookies. And then there'll be like some reflective material on set. And I'm like, oh my God. I mean, I give myself mini heart attacks all the time because I look absolutely terrifying on the outside, but I'm lovely on the inside. Hashtag humble brag.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
That's good. Thanks.
Hi.
Hi.
What first got you into acting?
I just always wanted to be on the telly. I don't know why. My parents are really shy and quiet. I don't come from like a loud, dramatic family, but I've been this annoying since I was born. And no one really knew what to do with me. My German family said I belonged in the circus. Bit harsh. So I just didn't know what to sort of do with myself. I was always singing and dancing and hyperactive and wanted to make people laugh and wanted to make people feel good and wanted to entertain people, but it never really sort of got directed anywhere. So it wasn't until, I mean, maybe when I was like 16, I sort of took a drama class at school, which was rubbish. But I always just like, I remember being a little girl and watching like Alphabetti spaghetti commercials. Like, I could do that. I could totally eat on TV and like nail that scene. But I just, it wasn't until I was 16, 17 that I started saying, okay, how do I do this? How do I find an agent? You know, I think I just was born this way.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Also, what was your favorite scene to film?
Well, I already mentioned the one where I was with Lana for the first time. That one I really enjoyed. And I really enjoyed filming the scene with Mr. Gold where we had that long dinner scene. That was really fun. I think my favorite scenes to shoot on Once Upon a Time tend to be where it's just me and one other person. Because sometimes there's a lot of us in a scene. So, you know, you're all standing there going, it's my line in a minute. Hang on, hang on. And there it is. Where, wait, it's my...
Wait for it.
And there's my line. So when it's just two people, like as an actor, it's a bit more fun because you really get to get your teeth into the scene because it's like one-on-one and you're really in it. So my favorite scenes were one-on-one with Lana and one-on-one with Rumpel.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello.
Hi, Snow White.
Hello. I was wondering if there was maybe any scene where it was just really hard to film because you were just burst out laughing all the time, because a lot of your scenes are you being like super serious. I'm really, really the bad guy.
Yeah, I do. We do. There is a lot of breaking and a lot of laughter. There was a scene that I did with Jennifer Goodwin where nobody knew who I was yet in Storybrooke, and I was kind of like, you know, Mary Poppins and the nanny. And that was really fun to play when nobody knew who I was. That was really, really fun. And there's that scene in the diner. I'm like, oh, you know, I can totally help you take care of your baby. Absolutely. And she's like, oh my God, that would be so great. And so I lean over and I'm like rubbing her pregnant belly, which is really disturbing in many ways. And I'm sort of rubbing it. And it's my coverage and Jennifer Goodwin sitting down there in a booth and I'm like rubbing her belly. And nobody said cut. So I'm just rubbing her belly. And I'm like, but this is still happening. Why am I still rubbing? And she's really pregnant too. So I'm like, okay, now I'm really rubbing this unborn child. And the camera was right there. So finally I just like was like, and just like pulled a stupid face. And she's like, Jennifer Goodwin was like, she's like, they're gonna hate you. I'm like, I know. So there was a lot of laughter on that. Like every time I had to touch her belly, me and Jennifer Goodwin are like, just trying not to laugh. And there's also another scene where I went up to Jennifer Goodwin and again, I'm touching this belly. I'm like, I'm gonna get your baby. And she's looking at me and it didn't make it into the episode, but the dialogue was a lot longer than made the cut. And I went on and on and on for about 20 minutes about all of my plans and what I'm gonna do. And I'd frozen her. So she couldn't move. And she's like, I could see her lip starting to quiver. I'm like, don't do it, don't do it. Don't lose it, let me get these words out. Oh my God, it was really funny. She, Jennifer Goodwin really makes me laugh. She's really funny.
All right, thank you. You look great, by the way.
Oh, thank you. So do you. Hello.
Hi. Well, my question was, did you find it hard to put a twist on The Wicked Witch based on how a lot of people have already done it?
No, I didn't find it hard. I think the whole thing about what wicked means in England and how I try to kind of just make it my own made it come easily to me because I wasn't trying to do somebody else's interpretation of that character. I'm like, whatever, I'm just gonna do the Rebecca Mader version and hope I don't, you know, get fired after one episode. So whatever I did was just my own thing once I'd been given really good writing, you know? Okay. So it was easy, it came easily to me, which makes it more fun. Because if it's a struggle, that's not fun to go to work. I bounce out of bed in the morning because I just, you know, embodied that character very, very easily, which is probably not a good thing that being so horrible comes so easily to me now that I think about it. But anyway, it was really fun.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
Okay, so on the show there are several different ships.
There's what?
Ships, like they're, that's what they call them, ships.
Oh, ships. Yeah. Oh, God.
So.
It's one of those.
Well, so I know that Zelina kind of had a thing for Rumpel, but other than him, if she could have been in a ship with anyone, who would you choose?
I think someone new needs to come to town. I mean, The Wizard of Oz was quite hot. I've worked with Christopher Gorham before on Covert Affairs. I don't want to break up any current ships. I don't want to die. So if Zelina was going to have a ship, they would have to fly in someone new on a different broomstick for her, I think.
Okay. And which ship is your favorite?
Huh?
Which is your favorite current ship?
I don't have one.
Okay.
I can never go there until the day I die. I will never say that.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hello. Hello.
Hello.
I was wondering, the day of the shoot, what is that one routine, that one thing that you just can't do without?
It takes a long time to get ready, right? So the hair, you know, the makeup takes an hour and a half. The hair takes another half an hour. Then someone else has to put my clothes on for me because you can't put those costumes on myself.
But for you yourself, like the one thing that like you get into
No,
yourself.
I know, I'm telling you.
Oh,
so it takes, this is the process, right? Uh-huh. It's like an hour and a half of the makeup, half an hour of the hair, half an hour to get dressed, and then everybody leaves me alone. So then I have a minute, then I run my lines. I'm like, okay, I know my lines. And then I look in the mirror and look at how, I mean, because it's just the reflection is so obviously completely different to what I look like. And I take myself in and then I'm like, all right, let's do this.
Yeah.
Boom. And I kick the trailer door open. I'm like, where are they? And off I go. And it's that moment of just letting everybody's hard work settle in. It's all come together. Take it in and then go out there and kick some bum.
You become her.
Thank care. You very much. Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
So there are a lot of action sequences in Once Upon a Time that involve swords, daggers, crossbows, that kind of stuff. Do you wish you had done more action-y sequences like that?
Well, I mean, for me, flying on my broomstick is an action scene. It's incredibly physical and really, really, really grueling. So that, for me, was my broomstick is like Hook's hook and, you know, Robin Hood's bow. We all have our thing. And I mean, I did get quite a lot of action. That you know, the Wicked West standoff between the two sisters at sundown, that was epic. That was a huge action scene where I'm throwing Regina all over town. That was pretty epic, and that took all night to shoot. I think we finished about 6 o'clock in the morning, and it was so cold, but it was so much fun. So I feel like Zelina definitely got some action.
And my second question is, out of all the weapons that Once Upon a Time uses, which one would you like to wield?
I mean, I do like holding the dagger. I do. Feels really good in the palm of my hand. It's such a powerful, it's the most powerful thing on Once Upon a Time. And controlling Rumpelstiltskin and Mr. Gold with that felt excellent.
Cool, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Cheerio and welcome to the other side of the pond. How are you?
Sorry, what?
I said cheerio and welcome to the other side of the pond.
Hello, darling.
You looked like you were having a lot of fun in Once Upon a Time, and I would love to see you play the master on Doctor Who. I think you would be perfect for the role. That being said, what was it like working beside Robert Carlyle, especially in his role as Rumpelstiltskin?
I mean, Robert Carlyle is such an iconic actor. He's hugely, hugely famous in the UK. I grew up watching him on TV as a child. So for me, I mean, I scored a lot of points with my mum and dad, you know, to work with him. They couldn't believe it, you know. And he's just one of the greats. So to work with someone like that is just amazing, because when we were in the scene, we were just lost in it, you know. And we just always knew what we were doing, and whenever he and I had scenes to shoot, we'd get them done in like 5 minutes, and everyone was like, yay, we get to go home. It was very easy and very fluid, and because he's British, we share a love of tea. So there's a lot of tea and a lot of chatting and a lot of laughter, and having him on set you know, it's nice. There's so many Brits on the show. So, you know, hanging around with a bunch of Brits and drinking tea is like I could almost be in England. And I think you're right about Doctor Who, too. So thank you.
Sure. Enjoy your day.
Thank you so much. Hello.
Hi. What was the most awkward scene you shot?
Well, kissing on camera is really weird. So maybe kissing Mr. Gold was a little bit awkward. It's a bit weird. You know, it's never normal to do a kissing scene or a more than kissing scene as an actor. So that's a little bit weird, especially when you're friends with someone and you're mates. It's like, hello. Like I had a kissing scene on Lost with Sawyer and that was just so awkward. He was like my brother. I'm like, this feels so, so unsexy. And the director's like, pretend that you really like her. It's like, I'm trying. I'm like, oh God, thanks a lot. So yeah, I think kissing scenes are really awkward as an actor.
Thank you.
Thank you.
So, do you freeze everybody? Like superpower to Frozen?
Do you freeze
everybody?
I mean, he's probably asking, like, you know, how often do you use like your powers on a show, like?
Yeah.
How often?
Yeah.
I mean, I think I only froze everyone once. There was only one scene in 417 where I flew out of the air and then froze all the other actors, which was really, really fun because they could literally stand there and do nothing while I walked around. I'm like, I wish I could do this in real life. This is really, really fun. I'm a fan of freezing people, definitely.
So how you get that power?
I was born with it. All of the powers that Zelina has, she was born with.
Damn.
I know. It's a gift, yo.
I wish I have a fire.
A what?
I wish I have a superpower.
Like to conjure fire.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, work on it. Anything's possible.
So that's about it.
Well, thank you for your question.
And you're so beautiful.
Thank you. Aww. Thank you, darling. Very kind of you. Hello.
If there was any other show that you could be on, you know, just any other show, what would
it be? Any other show? Oh, God, there's loads. I watch so much television. I love TV. If I'm not making a TV show, I'm watching a TV show. I have no life. I would like to be on Doctor Who as a female doctor. That's my dream role. It's about time. Hello, girl power. I want to be a female Doctor Who. That's my absolute dream role because I started watching Doctor Who when I was 4 with my dad. And then I would love to be on Downton Abbey. Oh, God, I love that show. And then also Game of Thrones. Oh, I love TV. The TV is so good now. So anything like that, or even something new that comes up, or even if you write something good, I'll be on your show. So let me know.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, darling.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Actually, with that being said, since you said you would love to be on a Doctor Who as the first female doctor, out of all the doctors we've had for all these decades, which one has been your favorite?
I can't remember his name. What's the bloke? Oh, God, I was really young. What's the bloke called, the doctor that had that ridiculous scarf? Thank you! Number four was my jam. He's Doctor Who to me in my heart. Love him.
Yeah. Actually, since we're all here right now, and I really want, just for the inner dork in me, I want to hear you do the Wicked Witch laugh.
It's actually mine, but all right.
So very evil. Love it. Love it.
Very wicked.
I used to get into a lot of trouble with my laugh at school because I'm so loud. And, you know, someone, you know, would whisper something to me in class. I'm like... And they're like, get out. I'm like, what? They're like, stop screaming. I'm like, I laughed. They're like, no, you didn't. You go to the headmaster's office right now, young lady. I'm like, bloody hell. I was laughing. I can't do anything quite. Even my sneeze is ridiculous.
Yeah, one of those really loud, it's like, gotcha! Kind of things.
It's like, woohoo! It's awful. It's awful.
You're bad.
We have time for a couple more questions. Don't be shy. Come on down. Anything you guys can think of. Please. Yeah.
Come on.
Come on.
We got 2 brave souls. 3 brave souls. 4 brave souls. 5.
Hi, it's not really a question, more of a can you kind of say something so I can record it for my sister who couldn't be here today kind of thing?
Just record a video.
Something you record something for.
Oh, thank you.
Well, yeah, my sister's like a big fan and she wanted to come meet
what's
like
name?
Amy.
Hi, Amy, I wish you were here.
Okay, hold up. There you go.
I take direction very well. I just do what I'm told. That's what we do as actors.
So you could say hi now.
Are we rolling?
Yes.
Action.
Hi, Amy. I wish you were here. Stay wicked, gorgeous. Mwah.
Thank you.
Woo!
Hi.
Hi there.
Hello.
First of all, big fan of the show. Really enjoyed your character.
Thank you.
Second, are you working on anything new that you can tell us about? Anything that's not necessarily under wraps?
Not a hair commercial. No, not a hair commercial. Because I'm worth it. I am, and I can't say what it is. It's really good, and it's a really, really, it's a really, really good secret, but my secret is about to come out in about 2 or 3 weeks. So the next time I see you, you'll be like, oh, okay, it was worth the wait. It's really good. Yeah, I promise.
There's a next time.
Yes.
All right, thank you. Have a good
one. Cheers, mate.
Was that actually like your senior quote in high school, because I'm worth it?
Yeah, it's better when I turn into it. You've got to turn into it. All right, I'll do it.
Oh, wow, she's actually going, okay.
Because I'm worth it.
It's all about the turn in. Hello.
You mentioned that you're really loud, so that's okay. I have a really loud laugh too, so anyway. Older horror movies, there would always be that one person that screams.
Yeah.
Which scream would you have wanted to do if any of those movies, if you've seen any of those?
I did a horror movie where I had to scream for the whole movie in 2003. And then after we wrapped, they told me that the sound didn't work and that they could hear dogs barking throughout the whole movie. True story. So there's these sound studios in Bucharest, and they rescue all these dogs. So during a scene, inside, you can hear outside. I'm like, brilliant. So cut two, I had to ADR, which means re-loop the sound, for the whole film in a sound booth in New York, going, oh my God, oh my God, no, no. For about 7 hours. It was the sickest thing. And I had like a pot of coffee, candy. I was like shaking. At one point, I fell backwards and hit my head on the wall. It was so intense. So I literally did all like 6 weeks of screaming again in 6 hours. It was brutal. I was drenched in sweat. But I do, screaming in horror movies is really fun. I would love to do another horror movie. I love horror movies. Love them. None of my friends like them. I can never get anybody to come to the cinema with me. It's really annoying.
Which is your favorite?
My all-time favorite horror movie is the first original Nightmare on Elm Street.
Yes.
Oh, yeah, that's a good one.
Yes.
Oh, I love it. I know all the words off by heart. I love that film. And Poltergeist is, that's really good too. I just love them.
Alrighty, thank you.
Thank you very much.
Can we actually get a horror movie scream, or would it be way too loud? Okay.
Do it again, I wasn't looking.
That's all you get, dear.
Hi.
Hi.
Do you know Matt Smith and David Tennant, right?
Sorry?
Matt Smith and David Tennant?
Oh, yeah.
If you were to pick David Tennant or Matt Smith to date, who would you pick?
It's another ship question.
Why can't I have both?
Oh, go on, please.
I pick both. Why not?
I pick both too.
It's 2015, people. Yeah, life's too short. Actually,
there are shows about that. So.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
How does it feel to be so misunderstood?
It's horrible. It's really hard.
Isn't it?
It's really hard.
It's just heartbreaking. And I felt for you so much.
Thank you.
So my biggest question, you know Wicked, right?
Yes.
Okay. Would you have rather had a happy ending like Wicked, or do you like your ending?
Well, apparently villains don't get happy endings on Once Upon a Time.
Apparently.
Mm-hmm. Girl. I mean, I'm very, very cheesy as a person. I love cheese. I love happy endings. I do. I like crying. I watch a lot of shows that make me cry. I love Parenthood. I'm a big girl's blouse. So yeah, it would have been nice. I do love a happy ending, I'm not gonna lie.
Yeah, I wish you had a Fiero.
Yeah. Thank you. That'd be
fun. Thank you.
Thank you for your question.
I have returned.
Oh God.
I'm sorry, but I really want to come up here and ask. You like Doctor Who, correct?
Correct.
When you said you wanted to do a female doctor, is it possible I could record you doing a demo?
Yeah, you might have to call me agent. But, probably not.
Oh.
No.
All right.
But, tweet about it, and I'll retweet it. How's that?
Oh. It's worth it. All right.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hello.
Okay, so I'm a huge fan of the show, but I just wanted to know, since you're so sweet, or you seem sweet in real life.
Just an actress. I'm horrible.
How, like, was it difficult to be rude and so mean and so dark?
Weirdly, no. Because it should be. Because, I'm all about making people feel good. I'm a very loving person. I'm very maternal. I want everybody to be happy and... You know, I'm very much a caretaking kind of person. So it should be really hard for me to be so horrible, but it comes so easily to me. I don't know what that means. I should probably speak to a therapist. But it just feels so good. Maybe because I am such a nice person in real life, it's just incredibly cathartic to let out all the things I wish I could have said and could have done, but couldn't, and just throw it all into one character. Maybe that's what it is. It's an outlet.
Well, good job. You did an amazing job.
Thank you very much. Very kind.
Hello.
Hello.
You spoke earlier about how you had to get spray painted to be green. I'm really curious. Was that washable, or did you have to like keep that on for a day or two?
Oh, my God. I mean, once that stuff is on, it is on. So the removal process, obviously, you know, we would take it off at the end of every day because I couldn't leave set green and terrorize everybody in the hotel.
Why not?
Especially when my character was a secret, you know, I'm like, oh, do it when I get home. They're like, you can't. I'm like, oh, okay. So the removal process takes about half an hour and it takes three people. So it takes one person to put it on and three people to get it off because at the end of the day, everybody's just driven off. Captain Hook, nanite, Evil Queen, nanite. And I'm sitting like, trying to get it off. And they're all in bed. So... The way to get it off, the only way you can take off that green paint is with an oil-based makeup remover and loads of hot towels and really, really, really hard scrubbing. So once it's all come off, I'm completely bright red. It's really attractive. But then I wake up the next day and I've got like green behind my ear. Or, you know, I'm like, what is... I'm like, oh, brilliant.
All right. Thank you.
Thank you.
From green to red.
Hi, it's really nice to meet you.
Hello.
My question is, who was the biggest prankster or goof on set?
Biggest what?
Like prankster or goof?
Well, we haven't really, I mean, they're not like, I've worked on some shows where they do horrible things to each other, like really awful pranks. But everyone on this show is pretty good about that, because I think once you start that, it's game over, then it's just constant. So there aren't a lot of prankstering-ings happening, but there's a lot of silliness on the show. But most of us are very, very childish. So there isn't really anyone that's like super serious. Everyone's very, very, very silly. It's like what I said before. It's like being at university. Everyone's in their 30s, but everyone's acting like they're 14. Everyone's really silly.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Hello again.
Hello.
Yes, my question was, if you were to be the director, but you know, the show is still there. If you were to change just one scene, what would it be? What scene would you change?
I would have liked to have seen more about the wedding between Rumpel and Belle. and their dance. Maybe their dance could have been a little bit longer. I just love their relationship. Maybe that.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Hi.
Hi.
Thank you for taking the time to answer our questions.
And of course.
I wondered, through your journey to gain acting success, what was your most challenging audition that you ever had to go through, and how did you overcome the, I guess, the casting director's demands regarding that audition?
God, I've been on so many in 14 years. Some of them have been, oh my God. I mean, there's, I can't think of one specifically. But there are times, like when you're testing for a TV show, which is a horrendous experience, because you have to test for the network and then you have to test for the studio. And there's like an auditorium full of people just like, come on then, what you got? And you just, and you're so nervous. I mean, there's been auditions before where I've gone in and people are just texting. They're not even watching. Like, brilliant, do you want to make a phone call as well? Excellent. They're not even looking at what you're doing. I've had some horrendous, horrendous experiences. Also, or like sometimes I walk into a room and everyone's silent, which is weird, you know? I'm such a friendly person. I'm like, hiya, how is everyone? You all right? Crickets. I'm like, really? No one's gonna say anything. Excellent, totally normal. I mean, the casting process is hideous, hideous. It's very, very odd, very, very surreal.
Thank you.
Thank you.
All right, we have time for one final question.
Hi.
Just for one final, aww. Yeah, just for one final question. I'm sorry.
No, well, the they're mean.
Hello.
Hello. So what, Once Upon a Time, what character would you be if you weren't Zelina?
Oh, I already answered that question. If I wasn't Zelina, then I would love to be Rumpelstiltskin, because he's my favorite character.
Thank you.
You look really cute, by the way.
Thank you.
All right, the lady that was going to ask a question, I guess we have time for one more.
Yeah.
Someone else is in line.
Yo! Stop it!
Hey guys, look who it is!
That grumpy. He's so naughty.
Hello.
Hello.
I have a question.
If my wife dies in a bizarre gardening accident, will you marry me?
Woo!
Because you're worth it, yes. I do, Kevin, I do. Sorry, Phyllis.
No worries.
Hello.
Hi. I wanted to ask you a quick question because I was a big fan of Lost.
Yeah.
So I guess like an idea of how you liked it and what do you think about the finale of the show?
Oh my God, I've been asked about the Lost finale so many times. Some people hated it. Some people loved it. Being on Lost was one of the best things that's ever happened to me. I mean, living in Hawaii, being on that show, it was such a special TV show. It changed TV forever. It made sci-fi cool to the mainstream, which I think was really important for television. And I personally like the finale because, as I said before, I'm a very, very cheesy person. So lots of things weren't answered. As a sci-fi geek, that was a little bit disappointing, but there was a lot of stuff about the relationships and I cried my eyes out. So I was emotionally moved by it, which, you know, pleased me.
That happened to me too, so.